So yo, what is up, guys? I'm back, and obviously, I can't speak. Obviously, I'm here with my motorized bike, but this thing has not been well. So everything in the motor is fine. It's none of this. Is that leaking oil again? Crap. Well, maybe that. But the back wheel is completely shot. The bearings are coming out, and my chain is too small. And so before I get this into tip-top competition, I'm gonna have to get this into tip-top decommission. But this thing's getting a nice little wash and all that, and I actually have a few new parts coming in. I have a new not an exhaust, but I will be having a muffler, you know, the new cylinder head and the new CDI, which is the Thunderhead CDI. Maybe a new magneto, just maybe, but I'm not too sure. But also, I actually am here with my Gucci slides, so yeah. Shout out to, the Bucci. But anyways, I'm gonna get this out of the chain out, so you're gonna watch me do that real quick. Today I got super scared because I thought I lost this little peg piece that goes into here, which is mandatory for the clutch. But thankfully, it was in my, oh my god, I just noticed that, wow. What the hell? Well, it was in my toolbox, and I'm gonna get a band-aid. That's patched up. But anyways, I'm gonna wash this bike real quick, and then I'm gonna fast forward to around a week or so when I get the new parts. So you're gonna see that in an instant. Well, it's late, and I just spent all day working on that bike. Whew. I was gonna record earlier, but I didn't get, any footage because I was busy. But anyways, I'll kind of show you what I did today. And I'm gonna be quiet because I don't wanna wake anybody up. But anyways, I got this new Thunderhead CDI, which is what I was talking about. And you see, there's the whole key slot right there. And the Thunder ignition coil. So that's the ignition coil, that's the CDI. Which this thing is like 2.5 times bigger than the old one, and this is the size of the old one. Then this is the high compression cylinder head. You see how big this thing is compared to the old one. The old one went to like here. Now it's up to here. It has more compression because it has a less, bigger kind of dome. I don't want to say dome, but here's something I had to risk. Also, I put a new fuel line on and a fuel filter, but I had to bang the frame in with a hammer just so I can get this on, because this thing would have not cleared, and I could have got a different engine mount, but I didn't because I'm an idiot. But I got to keep the expansion exhaust on, thank God, because the problem why I noticed is this thing wasn't staying on. It wasn't able to go on because of the way it was positioned before I did this, because the engine was sticking like almost sideways out towards me, and there would have been so many problems with like what I did a few days ago to show you guys. But I fixed that, so thankfully I got the expansion exhaust on, no muffler. I'm just gonna go no muffler because it's freaking loud. But yeah, anyways, this is kind of what I've been showing you guys. In a few days I'm gonna upload a video of me putting on my new wheels or rims. So I got these aluminum mag rims coming in, so stay tuned for that.